attending this talk and seminar this morning, and thank you for being here with us, moderator, which speak about particle efficiency. So efficiency is like the generic type, time efficiency, energy efficiency. Now let me, there have been a lot of interesting and important discussions, but let me, because you are basically a business chairman, let me say how I look at your problems, or how government looks at your problems, and how I solve it. It's more of an algorithm, rather than taking a fixed view and then working on that. So we first try to improve, as you know, generation capacity. We first tried to improve the generation capacity, and we have largely been able to do so. But then, generating electricity is not good enough. I'll come down to other issues. We have to take care of the customers, provide a quality electricity, reliable electricity, uninterrupted electricity. Their job is yet to be done. So I think if you ask me, priority, as I look forward, that whatever capacity we have developed, we must have a transmission network, a reliable transmission network, a reliable distribution network, which will ensure that the customer get reliable quality. And we are working on that. If I have more time, I would say how we are working in terms of BTPs, from finance to projects to implementation. I could go down to each of them. But if you take my words for granted, I can assure you another 2 years' time, all these efforts will be in place and function. Someone raised the question about system loss. We know at once upon a time to be around 30%. We are close to plan to go single digit, inshallah, by next year. We are around 10% now. So I think that's been a huge improvement on energy loss, which we have to say. Now, if we fell beyond, let's say next year, this would be important for those who have industry, but those who are trying to plan in the industry, they will look for longer time frame. But we have to leave tomorrow to plan for the afternoon. So next year, there has been, you know, gas shortage all these years. Next year, inshallah, we will be able to increase gas supply by 50%. It's not 500, we'll have 500 and another 500, 1000 MMCFD of gas flowing into the system. So that would significantly ameliorate the gas shortage in quantitative terms. Next, the question comes, what would be the price? People have gone into discussions about blending and, you know, what about international price and, you know, I don't get into those details, but whatever the international price, you have to buy at that price. There has been an understanding that no taxes on the sale. But even then, we'll have to blend and sell. Our secretary has been calling some of you, I don't know whether you have met him, to share with you the likely price regime and what you can afford, and try to kind of understand your cash flow system. Our government has always been ready to support industries. Our Prime Minister's single motto is to develop the country, and focusing on developing the country. And so, if there are financial support that needs to build into the pricing system, for you all to, you know, improve your efficiency, to absorb this cost increase, we'll certainly talk about it. But I can assure you, inshallah, next year we'll have, first half of next year we'll have 500 MMCFD, and following that, the second half we'll have another 500 MMCFD of gas, which will almost raise 40% gas supply to the system. Now next, because it's tied up with this, you know, we are setting up special economic zone, and the question came, how to support this mission. There are a couple of alternatives available to you. Let's say there are private sectors who are setting up economic zone. We would like to provide quality electricity. We have talked about it in the how that can be ensured to the special economic zone. And I request all of those who are either have proposed special economic zone or those who plan to establish special economic zone to come and discuss with us as to how we can ensure quality electricity. But here I have a solution which I would like to encourage you to look into. You know, if we have a simple cycle, power cut, even HO4 and power cut, and if you can cogenerate and trigenerate that system, then your energy efficiency will go up about 80 to 90%. Now, how you can do that? If you plan your special economic zone in such a way that there are people who will utilize heat, and then maybe some will utilize heat for freezing, then this simple reciprocating engine whose electricity efficiency will be 40%. But then you take the waste heat. I'm going to give you details because you are all serious people, so I want you to. If you take the waste heat, run some boilers, and then when the temperature goes down, take it for refrigeration, then you raise your energy efficiency by 80% or even more. That means you will be able to absorb much higher cost also. Or if the cost is low, then you enhance your margin. So I am proposing that distance C, and that place was chosen for a power plant of 30-20 megawatts. And it's coming up now. It's unbelievable. The coal for importing coal, the system is being put in place. These guys have gone and looked around to try to buy mines, which are also being discussed, so that we source our coal in the mine, if not 100%. And then evacuation system is being worked out. It's like having something in the moon, actually. I was so impressed. I didn't believe that so much can be done. So yes, I think Hashem is there. The other day, the contract was signed, single largest contract in Bangladesh for Marwari water, $2.5 billion. A port is coming up. We don't need this port for Pyra. Pyra is Pyra. This Padabadi will help, you know, the hub, power hub that we are creating. There will be a deep sea port there. Work is on progress. There will be 200 megawatt power plant there. Well, and you know, a $2.5 billion single contract, Bangladesh, I guess there must be the largest single contract. So, it's also, you know, the Rampal power project is also coming online. But let me tell you one thing, you know. Many of you were raising the question, but I know you don't, every one of you is not there in every meeting. We have spent a lot of time looking into the scientific aspect of mining coal in the north. We've gone deep into the science of it. Somebody mentioned that you are not serious. You don't know how much of spine you have spent, how much of depth you have gone into. But before I explain that, let me tell you, many of us don't know that how small a country Bangladesh is and how big a country it is. Take a quarter of France. You know, France, take a quarter of France. Put in all the French population in that place. Put in all the German population in this place. Put in all the Danish population in this place. Put all the Norwegian population in this place. That is Bangladesh. Such a small space. You must remember that. You know, we keep on forgetting. It's such a small country with a large population. But inshallah, we've done extremely well. North Bengal is very rich in agriculture. There is a large aquifer that runs underneath the coal mine. If you want to mine that place, you are going to disturb that coal aquifer that runs from Himalaya down to North Bengal. And then we have done some modeling also. Not even in around Borobudur area. The Institute of Water Modeling had done it for us. We did some readings to see how much of the aquifer would be disturbed. And it's much too risky. North Bengal, even if this few underground mine local aquifer that want to become conical. In a large place, if you go, you don't know. There are some technologies which ring-fence the mine. So the mine is ring-fenced and then you dry it. But these are more experimental. So, Bangladesh, in its own way, we have been able to raise food when the population down, our food production has gone 3 times. So it should be, there is a balance with which you have to. Somebody said that it will never be utilized again. There is no romance about it. If you can go, proceed, go ahead, if someday everything is abandoned and renewable energy takes the place, so be it. So, but while we look at this, if I then take a step forward, 3 years down the road, coal-based power plant that could take very long. 7 years, 6 years, minimum time. Exploration, oil and gas exploration in deep sea. If we find something today, we can expect 10 years. So while you plan those things, you have to live those 10 years. We have already given to Daewoo and Cosco 2 blocks. Because of the low oil price, those who are interested in the, our incentive is comparable to any other country's incentive for oil and gas exploration in the deep sea. But then, countries have expressed that at this price, they cannot. Statoil was here. I spent hours with them. I said, what do you want to leave you there? But come and Statoil is a very famous, very dependable company. They were really trying to bank check. But then they changed their mind. So, I can't force an investor, but the point is, at this price, deep sea oil and gas exploration is not very viable for investors, unless they find some new technology or things which will make difference in cost. So we cannot rely on that and stop our, we have to, hoping that they will come, hoping that things will change, we have to take other measures as well. Because I can tell you that, please come 5 years later and if things happen, go and set up investing. We have to make sure, even through these challenges, we find pathways to go ahead. So, as you have heard, we are trying to set up some 5-year vita IPPs, regional individual. This is because that gap, next 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and we have to fill it. It's no use arguing. And we want to be ahead of the curve. If the demand is X, we want to have X plus delta something. And be able to transmit, distribute them. So we have seen that in another 3-4 years before these large coal-fired power plants, Pyram will be coming in the first year of 2019, there is a slippage in power. Mr. Carson is there, power engineer, 6 months, slippage is nothing for them. Yeah, 6 months, a year. We have to fill in that land. And the only way you can do it is to have some liquid fuel-based power plants. Those who say about increasing efficiency of existing power plants already do that. We are retrofitting some or replacing some of this industry. But we can't let the power demand be unsatisfied. And the industry that are coming up, the demand is being expected to generate housing and others, per capita, not only connection, we are hoping to, inshallah, have the country connected by next year, most of the countries. But that is connectivity. But then, they start consuming electricity, we provide reliable electricity, per capita income goes up, per capita electricity consumption goes up. It's a cycle. And that cycle we have to meet with specific actions on ground. I can't say that we have to send electricity. In the same way, with respect to primary energy, as I say, we have, inshallah, next year, 1000 MMCFD, and then we have plans to set up renovated LNG and maybe another one to FSRU, hoping that about 4000 MMCFD we have. This can be done, the FSRU can be done faster. So about 4000 MMCFD of gas we have in mind next few years. With that gas, we may also provide, you know, but I'm sure that those who are, have captive power plants and all, they must have coal generation, time generation, or else they can't afford these prices. And we have talked in earlier meetings also, where Tita's is also providing some energy audit, but I think you are now smart enough to have energy audit done and start retrofitting your industry. The payback period I've seen in maybe a year, 9 months. I would like to the younger ones. I see many who have been, you know, friends for a long time. They might be tired, but their children must have come and taken the reins. So please ask them to those who want find out how energy efficiency can be. In a longer haul, you know, as I said, coal would be a major plank. And the gentleman did mention nuclear energy. Also, you know, there is a research going on modular nuclear energy, 100 200 megawatt plug and play. Some of them are already applied for license in the United States. And Bill Gates has invested heavily in this modular nuclear power plant. We are keeping track of that, whether if it is available, we would like to accept that. But Kukuk is coming in any case, the bigger nuclear power plant. Regional connectivity we are pursuing. We will be able to, will be soon, it will go up about 1100 megawatt. We are also considering quite a GMR, a company we are signing MOU for bringing the electricity from Nepal. For Bhutan also, it's in progress. GMR is not because by me. Someone mentioned about Myanmar, and at least I can feel proud that at least I thought of it 5 years back. I myself traveled to Myanmar and talked to the authorities, saying that, look, definitely, you know, different between neighbors, but that's not hold us cooperative. And I think I was about to convince them that your gas in like a situation plant where they had some excess. I said, you want to generate electricity. We have power plants sitting idle in Chile. You provide us this gas, we provide you electricity. And the Rakhine state is there is a mountain going north south. So it would be very tough for them to be electricity there. So this was before the election. And they bought in the idea. I said, look, you know, and when if you get bigger results, then you have to look for customers. And in the west side, you have customers. So they decided to send a team. But then the election came, and then the Rohingya issue came again. But our president is working very hard to see. And I'm hopeful, inshallah, that we'll be able to have gas and electricity connectivity in Myanmar. And other trades should also flourish. And there are private sector here, you know, why don't you go and try to work as a facilitator on these ideas? At times, you know, government to government ideas are tough to, you know, bring on a negotiating table. So you can do some behind the wall scene and earn some money too, I'm sure. There are ways you find out to earn some money. So I am requesting to do that. One other point, you know, I think, I don't know, time only to say whether we are smart or he's smart. But Adani is setting up a 1200 megawatt power plant in Dhaka. And there will be a dedicated line to Bangladesh. And we'll buy that electricity. We have negotiated the price of, I think it's about 6 Dhaka, if I'm not mistaken. So the power plant will be in Dhaka, slightly And then you produce electricity, and a dedicated transmission line will come to Bangladesh and Dubai. About energy price, then, I should not say, we are going to import it. So it will depend on the import price. We have a MOU with Qatar, so we buy some, and we have a few stages. We buy some of the get LNG from Qatar, but we'll keep some option open to go and buy from spot market in short term. My guess is, LNG, but once you blend it, depending on whether it is 1,000 mm CFD or 500 mm CFD, you can work it out. But LNG, if you take energy efficiency measures, you can cut down your energy consumption. And we can work better. If there is a really harsh on some industries or some starting point, we can work better to make it at least what to do for you for a year or so. So, and I said, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, she has always come up with practical solutions, but sometimes very bold decisions. So, whether it is a practical solution or a bold decision about future, she will not be short in any of those things. You just have to let us know. And the biggest example is that Hassan Mansour working in one of those multilateral institutions, World Bank, trying to cut us down. But then he has a big service. We are off their home. We are on the road, on our own. And now coming to question made by Arbab and Mark, and my, no, we are already working on $1 billion bond issue by PDB. So that PDB can go out and access, start accessing. You are right, we are talking about $50 billion maybe investment. So it's a large amount of money we're talking about. Also, we are planning to, we are working to sell local bond by one of our power companies, maybe about 600 crore to 800 crore, which will come to the local market, so that we'll also give some depth to the capital market in Bangladesh. And,